On Nationwide this evening, tourism in the southeast. We visit two tourist attractions, one in Wexford and the other in County Waterford. We see how the Heritage Park in Wexford continues to draw visitors from near and far. And in Waterford, we learn about the history of the railway line, which has now opened as the Waterford Greenway. Now, tourism is big business in the southeast of the country, and here in County Waterford, a new tourist attraction has been opened. It's the Waterford Greenway. It stretches from Waterford City to Dungarvan, 46 kilometres in total, and it's built along the old Waterford to Mallow railway line. Well, we've been finding out about the history behind the rail track and also finding out about how communities right across the county have come together to make sure that the development of this amenity is second to none.
Throughout the mid-19th century, there was numerous plans to create railway lines throughout the whole country, and Waterford here was no different. In 1872, the Waterford and Dungarvan Lismore Railway Company was formed to construct a line between Waterford City, Dungarvan in the south of the county, and in towards Lismore in the west. Construction would have started around 1874 and completed in 1878 with an awful lot of construction work. We look currently at the viaducts that are in Kilmac Thomas and Durrow, etc. And we kind of think they're the big plans. And they were big objects, especially the tunnel in Ballyvoyle. But we also had to look at the amount of construction that took place outside that in terms of just purely the line and also the station house, signal boxes. There was also the fact too that at that time the machinery just wasn't there. We had 100 horses and 900 men involved in the construction in 1874. It gave even the wealthy people would have had a problem travelling into country at that point. And this allowed people from all over the country to connect with each other and like ways they could never before. It also affected industry in terms of agriculture, the ability to move cattle, to move to trade, and also, I mean, it was part of a major network between the United Kingdom and Ireland as a trade route.
The Dacia Greenway Group came together to promote the idea of turning the old railway line into an amenity.
Yeah, the railway line was here since 1878 and closed in 1967 to passenger trains and then commercial in 1982. So the track was here for the last 35 years. So I've seen it even as a child here coming down even into this tunnel. And we daring each other to run from one end to the other in complete pitch darkness, you know, quite a scary thing to do. So 2004, I walked this from Waterford to Dungarvan, and, you know, I saw the value of it. I said, this could be put into something, you know, that can be used as an amenity, be it from a social, health, economic, tourism driver into the future.
I live alongside the railway. Our farm bounds the railway. I have a great admiration for the engineering at the time. There were very few countries in the world had this transport system at that time, the time it was built. I can appreciate the great stonework and engineering, and I didn't want that to be destroyed.
With 46 kilometres in total length, the concerns of landowners and farmers along the Greenway had to be addressed.
There were no two farms the same, and the council dealt with each farmer individually. And on that arbitration committee, you had a farmer, a member of the IFA, and a council official, which was pretty reasonable. Some of the sheep farmers were worried about if there were dogs on with people walking, that to make sure they're on leads, and they look for sheep fencing, that the dogs couldn't go in on the farms, which is understandable.
I'm a photographer locally, and I got involved, I suppose, because I've been taking photographs there all along, and they asked me to come on board and help out with social media as well. When I started taking photographs initially, it was like a jungle just outside the tunnel there with water flowing out, maybe 5 or 6 inches of water, and now it's lovely finished surface.
In the space of 4 years ago when we formed, we felt at the time maybe there might be a 20 or 30% chance of it going ahead. And we said, look, we'll go, we'll campaign for it, see how, you know, what would happen. When Michael Welch then came on board as a county manager in 2014, such a determined man, pushed this forward. And now to think that 3 or 4 years later, this is what we have. There is other campaigns in the whole country at it for 20 years, 30 years, trying to get these old railway lines into greenways.
Following more than 30 years of disuse, there was a lot of work to be done.
When we took it over, it was all overgrown. It hadn't been maintained in about 30 years. So the first job that we had was to actually devegetate the whole thing so we could see what we were working with. And then just by the nature of the site, it's very difficult. Logistically, it's a nightmare because it's 46 kilometers long. It's very narrow, so you can only fit one lorry at a time on it, and there are very few access points. So logistically, to try to get the job done, it's very slow in its nature and very awkward. We had to cross the main road three times, so there's two large underpasses and a substantial bridge that you can see behind me. We have built 12 farm underpasses, 3 access bridges, 6 car parks, 48 kilometres of fencing, 50 farm machinery crossing points. And on the existing structures, the biggest challenges we had were we had to clear the Durrow Tunnel. It was flooded when we took it over. It was knee deep. We had to drain it out and put a new drainage system in. Beside it, the Durrow Viaduct, which was a metal structure, all had to be refurbished to get it back into safe condition again. The engineering and the local authority, we build roads, we build bridges, we're all the time building and providing infrastructure. But this is the first instance in my experience where we got so much buy-in and praise and thanks from the public. And I know that the guys have been working here on the site, got a great kick out of it, and they have a great sense of pride of what they've achieved here, you know.
Kilmac Thomas is midway on the Greenway, and the community there was eager to be an integral part of the plans.
Well, I suppose I've been living here all my life, and it's an area I love, and it's an area I want to see advance. And like a lot of Irish towns, it has declined down through the years, and businesses have been suffering. This concept of the Greenway, I think, will be crucial to its development. And we, as part of Kilmac Thomas Tidy Towns Riverwalk Committee, have developed some exits, entrances onto the Greenway, primarily to bring people off the Greenway and into our village. Well, the first thing we did was we would have built, the initial path would have been along the river bank, and it was less ambitious than what we ended up with. And then we found the need for access to the lovely park we have here. And to do that from the village, we needed to put a bridge across the river, but we also needed to put a bridge underneath the existing bridge and to extend that path then up into the Greenway, to bring people off the Greenway and to allow people, local people, to get onto the Greenway quite easily. People have taken ownership of it, and they're proud of it, and they call it our Greenway. And I that's one of the most satisfying things, that people have embraced it, and local people use it all the time. I've seen people cycling, I haven't seen cycling for 30 years. And it's going to be a benefit for the local people themselves, as well as the economy of the area.
The winner is Kilmac Thomas, because the village was dying, and several shops were half a closing now. So hopefully now this will give it a new lease of life.
I would say to any other group, and we had a few different groups visiting us, where there were a derelict railway, don't leave it go. Get public opinion behind you. Canvass your local councillors, get athletic clubs, cycling clubs, people that love the outdoors, get them behind you. Because if you let it go, it's gone forever.
And a note for your diary, on Wednesdays Nationwide next week, Anne and I will be taking to the Greenway. She'll be on a bike and I'll be on Shanksmere. You will not want to miss that. Nationwide next Wednesday at 7 o'clock. On Nationwide this evening, it's one of Ireland's newest tourist attractions and is expected to bring visitors from near and far. We take a trip from one end of the Waterford Greenway to the other. Along the way, we meet the locals and we hear of their hopes for the success of this wonderful new amenity. You're welcome to the programme and you're welcome to the Waterford Greenway.
This evening we're starting out our journey from the picturesque village of Kilmacthomas on this magnificent viaduct, which up to 50 years ago formed part of the main railway line between Waterford and Mallow.
Today it's the newly opened Waterford Greenway, 46 kilometres of track stretching from Waterford City to Dungarvan. It's designed for walking, for cycling and for running, and it has magnificent views of the River Shore, the Comeragh Mountains and the sea at Dungarvan Bay.
Well, Kilmacthomas is about halfway between Waterford and Dungarvan, so I'm pedalling away to Dungarvan and I'm going to take in the sights along the way.
And I'm going to head off now on Shanksmere towards Waterford City, so
off we go.
Off we go. Flying higher than the trees. Ooh, I love that you're so free and you keep coming back to me. Now, you might think I'm at a bit of a disadvantage taking on this half of the journey on foot, but I don't want you to be worrying about me. I have a trick or two up my sleeve. All will be revealed later. Oh, it'd be so much better. I'm coming into the old train station here in Kilmacthomas, where I'm meeting Richie Welsh, who I'm told knows everything about the Greenway.
Mary.
Hello, Richie. It's nice to meet you.
And you too. Welcome to Waterford Greenway.
Thank you very much. Well, I've only just started out, and already I'm impressed. This is an amazing amenity.
It's absolutely wonderful, isn't it?
Yeah. How did the Greenway come about?
Well, I suppose once upon a time it was a railway for 100 years or thereabouts, and all of a sudden the economics of that didn't work out, and it fell into a disuse over a couple of years, and then people started looking at it and started to say, my God, wouldn't this be a wonderful amenity for both, you know, the local community and for the broader public, and with a greater sense of recreational wisdom, where people are looking for health opportunities and wonderful cycling walking opportunities, and that's it. It evolved from where it was, that old railway decaying and decayed, into a wonderful, wonderful new amenity.
It's one thing having a vision, but there's an awful lot of hard work involved as well, and it's a great feat of engineering, the whole Greenway.
It's a wonderful feat of engineering because, I mean, that which existed as a railway wouldn't necessarily do what is now required, which is a wonderful surface, a really pleasant experience, wonderful architecture that had to be restored and renewed, three great viaducts, wonderful bridges, underpasses, and a great sense of engineering beauty combined with architectural beauty combined with recreational experience and opportunity.
Are you, when you're looking forward, seeing wonderful opportunities for enterprise?
Absolutely.
In areas?
I mean, they've already started. An awful lot of them are direct commercial opportunities for people themselves, because they, you know, we've had already new cafes, new accommodation facilities, and everything else goes like that. A wagon load of bike hire firms, but there's also a whole sort of range of other things that are hanging off it. I mean, just north from here, up in the Comeragh Mountains, the wonderful walking opportunities. Down south, the Copper Coast area, that's wonderful. Here in Kilmacthomas, the whole thing has kind of joined together. This is now a spine running through the county, and with norths and souths connected to it. This could be something
beautiful. A facility like this can only benefit the health and well-being of all its users. Rosari Keeley is coordinator with Waterford Sports Partnership.
Rosari, the setup here with the Greenway really must be so good for the ethos of the sports partnership.
Absolutely, it is really like all our Christmases have come together to get a facility like this that offers so much to such a wide variety of the, we say, people of Waterford and beyond. It's accessible, it's relatively flat, yeah. It's beautiful. Look at today, you just want to be out on it. It's good for the soul as much as for the heart in terms of physical activity. We have a number of walking programs, so we'd have various walks for older adults and people with disabilities. So they would be 11 o'clock in the morning at time of day, and we do different parts of the Greenway. It's 46 kilometres long, you have lots and lots of options. We have Bike for Life programs where we might use the Greenway for the first day or two when people, these would be typically women getting back on bikes.
Yeah.
And typically first couple of sessions, people are a little bit nervous. So it's a great place to get started and just get a bit of confidence up before you move back out onto the road. And more we're finding a lot of our work is around physical activity is actually impacting on people's mental health, and we're working with various partners in the whole mental health area using physical activity as because it really is what doctors are prescribing these days.
And the beauty of the Greenway, of course, Rosari, is that you don't have to be super fit to use it, and you can suit all ages.
Yeah, there's really something for everybody here on the Greenway. Whether you're 6 months old or 66 years old, there's something, and everybody is welcome. And it's a shared space, and it's just you can pick your own activity and go out and enjoy it.
78 years and 50 years married today.
Hi.
I wonder how far Mary has gone on her travels.
Uh-oh, there's Anne checking up on me. And the fact of the matter is I haven't come very far at all, because I've come into the village of Kilmacthomas. And who did I meet? Only Martin Morris. Now, Martin, you're a blow-in from Wexford.
But
how long have you been living here?
I'm living here about 12 years now, Mary.
Yeah.
And trying to get involved with the local community with the Greenway coming in.
Well, now, I know you're an accountant, so you would have your finger on the pulse when it comes to identifying the benefits of something like this.
No, we're seeing huge benefits already, Mary. We reckon by the end of May we'll already be up to 30 to 35 full and part-time jobs in the village already.
Extra?
Extra.
Wow.
By the end of the summer, we hope to be up to 50 extra jobs. And looking forward, we think in 2 years' time we'll be up to 100 extra jobs. Based directly off the Greenway.
Yeah.
We've been speaking to a lot of businesses lately, and the big word we're getting is confidence. They have huge confidence, huge optimism for the future. Virtually every business is talking about investing in their premises, upgrading their premises, you know, providing extra facilities for the tourists that are coming in. So it's really, really positive.
I look into the window of my mind.
Helen Ridgard, you're a local woman, born and bred in Kilmacthomas.
Yes, yeah, lived here all my life. Yeah.
So you must be very proud of the way the community has come together for the Greenway.
Yes, very proud indeed, especially seeing what we've come from. 5 years ago, all this side of the street was closed down.
Really?
The AIB closed down, which was devastating for the village. And then we had to get our act together, but lucky enough, manna from heaven came the Greenway, and there was the green shoots of the Greenway.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody came together and worked together, and now we have a totally different town. We have a town now that we can offer a different thing, I suppose.
What have you done today to make you feel proud? It's never too late to try. What have you done today to make you feel proud?
I would imagine you had a great day on the official opening.
Oh, it was brilliant. We just couldn't believe it. We were pinching ourselves watching it. I was down in the shop, I had to come out. The crowds, 10,000 people down the street, it was absolutely amazing. We haven't seen that in Kilmac since the actual fair days, I suppose, back in the 50s. And it was actually finally looking like a tourist town. We were like the West. There was cars going up and down with bikes on the back, and, you know, crowds walking down the street and strangers coming into the shops, and, you know, just they'd never heard of Kilmac. And that was the best thing. I think the open day really got the word out there that Kilmac is here and open for business, and that we want to see people in and we want to welcome in people in. You know, we've got the old hospitality that's all, you know, that's lost in the cities. We still have it here in abundance, and we're mad to show it off.
So what have you done today to make you feel proud? I want to break free.
Hello, folks, how are you?
It's thirsty work, this cycling, so I'm making a stop here at O'Mahony's Enduro to get a drink.
Hello.
Hello, folks, how are you?
Oh, hello, how are you?
Good, not a bother
Good.
At all.
Did you come a long ways?
Yes, I've been coming from Kilmac Thomas and I'm on the way to Dungarvan.
Oh,
and
gorgeous.
This is a lovely, lovely spot, a lovely yeah. quaint shop.
Thank
Helen.
You very much.
How
Thank
long
you.
Have you both been here?
Oh, I'm here since God was a boy.
No way. So you married in then, Helen?
I married in here 40 years ago.
And she made it when she married in.
Don't mind that. No.
And I guess with the Greenway and so forth, you get a lot of people coming in here looking for bottles of water.
An awful lot, right, yeah. We're a very popular little shop of biog, we're calling ourselves now. The kids love that. They say wow when they come in and see the little sweets and things, you know what I mean? But they need their energy on the walkway as well, you know.
And before the Waterford Greenway really took off, Helen, was it quiet around?
It was a much slower pace of life and business altogether, you know. We had our regular customers at night. You had the odd person dropping in for an ice cream or the newspaper or a packet of cigarettes, that kind of thing. It was slow.
And but what's it like now?
Oh, it's way different. We have streams of people coming in for, especially the two things that stand out by a long shot are ice cream and water. Absolutely, it's amazing.
Cycling and walking is thirsty weather.
It is thirsty work, yeah.
And Tom, how long have your family been here?
Over 100 years.
My goodness.
Yeah, and just here when the railway started, they started building the railway and the pub was here then, you know. And when they started building the tunnel, there was 200 working on it, making that tunnel at that time.
And I guess people would have stopped off here for refreshments.
Did. Yeah.
In the pub attached to the shop, PJ Marr and Donal Walsh have great railway memories.
I can see, PJ, from your uniform, it's the genuine article, and you worked with CIE for quite a few years on this line.
That's correct. I was the last man to operate Durrow Station before it closed.
And what was it like working at Durrow Station?
Well, Durrow was a station that was from, it never changed from the 18th century. It worked without any electricity. On the phone, we had no public phone, it was only station to station. And the reason I say that I got a job in Durrow Station was the gates were a problem in Durrow Station because we had the co-op next to the station and the passenger train came at the wrong time when all the horses and cows used to be coming in there for the milk. So I operated the gates as well, so I operated them with a motorbike.
So you could ensure
That's
safe
correct,
passage
yeah.
of the train
That's
and the animals?
Oh yeah, I'd come back up and I'd interlock the whole thing before I could pull the signals. Like you could say I was the evil Knievel of the, of the early 60s.
PJ, you were working here when the last train pulled out of Durrow. But Donald, you were a passenger on that train, isn't that correct?
That's it. I joined the train in Lismore on the last day of the service and got a ticket as far as Dungarvan. Previously I had done some amateur photography and I'd made a film of the railway between Lismore and Waterford. And so I had to be on the last train. But on the way between Dungarvan and Kilmac Thomas, the ticket collector came around and he caught me without any ticket. I had a ticket for the Lismore to Dungarvan section, but I got caught for an excess fare for Dungarvan to Kilmac Thomas.
You don't say.
Back on the Greenway again, and the Ballyvoyle Tunnel is just up the road. Johnny Brunnock is meeting me there.
You're very welcome to Ballyvoyle Tunnel.
Maybe we can walk and talk. What do you think?
Absolutely.
Yeah. This is a very intriguing, almost spooky, Johnny.
Absolutely. This is a magical place, I suppose. This is a tunnel that is here since the 1870s. It's 381 metres long, so I suppose a very unusual feature even on greenways here in Ireland and across Europe. Also very, very close access for families or for children who might want to come along. We're only 500 metres from the nearest car park, so it's a real I suppose attraction that is atmospheric. It was something I suppose that when the council was doing a little bit of the work on it initially, and maybe about 2 years ago, It was very overgrown. You could still access it, but there was drainage issues. So the whole lot was cleared pre-construction. The drainage was fixed.
And what about the alcoves that are dotted on either side of the trail?
Absolutely, they would have been, I suppose, there's alcoves dotted every 15 to 20 metres where the workers on the railway at the time would have stood back as the train would have passed along. Again, even within those alcoves, which have been lit recently as part of the works, and again, which sort of add to the atmosphere of the tunnel, there would be little, the water which is coming through the limestone would have calcified, and there's features such as stalagmites and stalactites which are part of the tunnel, and again make it just that little bit extra special. And I suppose the fact that it's now been made so accessible by the fact of the, you've got such a good tarmacadam surface, and you've got the car park which is very near as well.
And of course it's lit.
And of course it's lit, which really shows off everything that it has to offer.
You know, it's so atmospheric, it's almost like a rainforest here. Well, I wonder how Mary is getting on her walk. We're going to take a break now, and when we come back, we will be resuming both our journeys on the Waterford Greenway. We'll see you in a few minutes.
Well, you're welcome back to Nationwide, and we're still here on the new and the fabulous Waterford Greenway. Now, by my reckoning, Anne is probably about halfway to Dungarvan by now. I'm barely outside Kilmac Thomas, but you know what? I don't think I can go any further without a coffee. Coffee!
Garamahagut, Craig. Yeah, one of the things that I particularly like about the Greenway is that there are places like the coach house here where you can get a cup of coffee and sit down and rest your weary bones and then take off again. Cause I got a
peaceful evening. Hi there. Nice day.
The longest part of my walk leads me into Kilmeaden and the Waterford Shore Valley Railway. Maria Kite is the manager.
Hello, Maria.
Hello, Mary. You're very welcome.
Thank you very much. This is amazing. How long has this been on the go?
The Waterford and Shore Valley Railway has been operating for 15 years.
And now the Greenway is going right through it. That's very good news for you, isn't it?
Oh, it's brilliant news for us. I tell you, the last 2 weeks, it's just brought a new lease of life to the place. It's been absolutely fantastic.
So you're having lots more business on your railway because of people coming through the Greenway, isn't it?
Absolutely. And we're having lots more people enjoying coffee, sandwiches and cakes in our ticket office, which is a lovely Irish Rail carriage. We've people coming from Kilmac Thomas direction, from Waterford City, from Carriganore, from Kilateran, and obviously coming to our own car park as well.
Well, Maria, I can resist everything except temptation. I'm tempted to give up the walking for a little while and get onto the train, but nobody must say anything to Anne about this. So can I go on your train?
No problem. Here's a ticket.
Oh, thank you very much.
Always need a ticket. Okay. Enjoy.
Bye. Go.
Further on from the tunnel is yet another viaduct, but this one looks more modern. Andrew Kelly knows why.
Good to meet you, Andrew. Now, tell me, there's a story attached to this viaduct, isn't it?
Yeah, well, this was part of the original Waterford and Dungarvan Lismore Railway. And in 1922, the IRA came out and they bombed one arch in this, one arch on the road bridge to prevent Free State soldiers from advancing towards Dungarvan. And after 2 days, the second arch went on this bridge and eventually all collapsed. But the county surveyor at the time, John Bowen, was aware of what would happen in the road bridge, and he sent guys out and they propped between the arches to prevent it from falling. It actually had started to move. It had moved a few inches, but he propped it between, saved the bridge. What had happened this one was that the arches individually started collapsing. After about 2 weeks, all the arches collapsed in. And this was regarded being impossible to put back up again in stone. Mm. So they put this modern viaduct in here. And this was opened in 1924. I think it was in June 24 was the first train through after the event.
So one way or the other, you've got two very impressive bridges, viaducts within a stone's throw of each
other. Within a stone's throw of each other, yeah, absolutely, yeah.
As I leave the train, which is heading on towards Waterford City, I'm making a stop at the magnificent Mount Congreve Gardens. Ray Sinnott is the estate manager here.
Ray, could you ask for a nicer place to go walking of a spring day?
We don't think so. With the azalea hatsugiri out and many other azaleas out with the colours and scents, it is really gorgeous, it is.
I'm just thinking, isn't it a happy coincidence that the railway and the Greenway now stop right here at Mount Congreve?
For us, we think it's a great coincidence because it is, like you see, it's just literally you step off the train and you're into the garden. Mm-hmm. So for us, it's wonderful. And the Greenway has been a great success.
So for somebody who diverts from the Greenway and comes into the gardens, what can they expect?
Well, we have over 16 kilometres of paths spread throughout over 70 acres of wonderful gardens planted for something to see all year. We have a four-acre wall garden inside with the vegetables. We sell seasonal produce down there. There's just something to see for all year round. And it was designed by Mr. Congreve for the eye. So it always draws you in and draws you further. And it's just something to see all year round. Wonderful.
Hi, Anne.
How are you?
Almost at journey's end and heading into the town of Dungarvan, Lynn Cattle tells me about the tourism potential of this project.
The Waterford Greenway has really opened up and showcased Waterford in a way that it hasn't been before. It's bookended by Waterford City, Ireland's oldest city, and right down to here in Dungarvan. On one side you have the Copper Coast, which is just magnificent, and then you have the Comera Mountains on the other side, spectacular views of the Comera Mountains. It's really caught the imagination. I think particularly it's free, first of all, and you're out in the fresh air. It's a great appeal to families. It's completely off-road, so that's a huge appeal to people. You know, you're away from the traffic and the noise and the hustle and bustle of everyday life.
And one of the beauties of it, of course, is that it links city and county.
Yeah, it does in a way that it really hasn't happened before. And even Waterford people are saying, I never knew how beautiful it was. And, you know, you're really getting to immerse yourself in the countryside, but also in the heritage of Waterford and that old railway line. It was known as the most scenic railway line in Ireland, and you can really see why now.
Well, it's a jewel, really, and it's something that the whole country can be proud of.
Yeah, I think so. And, you know, it's another part of Ireland's ancient east and a really good attraction for international visitors as well.
Well, I've done what I set out to do, and I have to say it's been a wonderful experience travelling the Waterford Greenway. And so, from here in Dungarvan, it's time to say goodnight.
And I've made it to the outskirts of Waterford City, the WIT West Campus at Carriganore on the banks of the River Shore. I'm going to say goodnight to you now before continuing on to Journey's End in the city. I hope you've enjoyed this insight into this new wonderful amenity, the Waterford Greenway. Put it in the diary, a lovely thing to do on the long summer days and into the evenings. Iwagwiv agus Gadeshiv Slán.